Hello everyone, we at AdToday Forums welcome you for an evening to soak into the digital world. As we all know, digital today is going beyond the realms of just social media, hence it is important for the brands to engage their consumers across platforms.
Keeping in mind this notion, we at AdGilly Forums thought of getting the veterans under one roof and discuss the evolution of new media and the rise of smart user. Before we call upon our panelists, I would like to take you through the journey of AdGilly.
Founded by Mrs. Bijoya Ghosh, AdGilly came into existence on 15 September 2009. As rightly said, hard work and passion is the key to success. AdGilly fought all odds in the last 5 years and today gives strong competition to all. After catering to media, advertising and the entertainment industry for half a decade now, the dynamic lady thought of taking the baby all the more closer to its target audience. Without taking much of your time, I would now like to call upon our first speaker, Mr. Tanmay Mohanty, who is the Managing Director of Performix. He will also be moderating the session for us.
Now I would like to call upon Mr. Sanjay Tripathi, who is the Senior Executive Vice President, Marketing, Product, Digital and E-Commerce.
Giving a tough competition to all men, we have a vibrant lady, Dipali Nair.
Next, I would like to call upon Mr. Sandeep Tarkas, who is the President, Customer Strategy, Future Group and CEO, Bengal Warriors.
Our next panelist is Mr. Jairaj Jadhav. He heads e-business and digital marketing at Tata AIG.
Now, I would like to call upon Mr. Pradeep Dwivedi, who is the Chief Corporate Sales and Marketing Officer at Dainik Bhaskar Group.
Our next speaker is Mr. Ratish Nair, co-founder Ad Magnet.
Our next panelist is Mr. Adarsh Pete, who is the Marketing Manager, Digital Marketing at Adobe India.
Last but not the least, we have Mr. Ramesh Chembat, Associate Vice President and Head, Strategic Marketing, Retail Operations at Godrej Appliances.
We'll start this discussion. I don't have much to say. Enough people and a lot of knowledge in the room. Three things that we want to focus today is that given the way internet and mobile has come in India, how the economic value of a customer has changed.
If you know the internet over the last so many years, last like 10 to 15 years, the consumption pattern has changed across the board. So there's an entire ecosystem which has been created where the end consumer is not maybe the guy who's able to pay for it. It's the parents who are ending up paying for that thing, but it's a large ecosystem that's been consumed, and therefore the kind of content, the kind of information that gets consumed is like is much more than what we would have thought when we were at the same age.
I understand that the economic pattern of this customer has changed, but what I wanted to ask Sandeep is that does he see that the same way his customers actually interact with them?
Obviously, customers are changing a lot, their expectations are changing a lot. As they get exposed to more, they expect more from every interaction that they do with the brand.
Business model to give this content back to the consumer have changed, or are you planning to do that?
The media industry is undergoing a very fundamental transformation, and just because print appears to be a legacy business that hasn't transformed does not mean that it's not transforming. There are actually some very fundamental changes happening even in the way print industry is operating in terms of how it gathers information, how it repurposes that content to be made available both online and offline. So today you see manifestation of whatever content that we have in terms of it being available on our online portals, it being available through our web apps, whether it's on Android or iOS platforms. There is a certain audience that is emerging, not just in tier 2, tier 3 India, practically primarily starting from metros, but that's a trend that is kind of now prevailing pretty much across the country. With the advent of a better internet infrastructure, better speeds of operation, and most importantly, a device and an application ecosystem that allows access to information in an unfettered manner, the choices that are today available to the consumers are far too many.
When you are talking about the way things are changing in digital marketing, right now we have only seen one aspect of digital marketing, but the other aspect which evolved, especially when it came to Fairfax Media, was interestingly they started measuring the productivity of the correspondent by the consumption of the content which is going online.
On your topic, I have a simple question. The way your products have been designed or the marketing cloud that we were talking about, do you think that most of the marketers in India and some of the CMOs, top CMOs here, digital CMOs, but are they using it to do a real-time planning still? Are they planning to move it?
That's a litmus test and a tough question to answer. But Not as of now, but surely, you know, the way things are evolving out, and you know, the way you know, we are seeing the traction and the momentum coming up, definitely.
This multi-channel data, that social, the content platforms, and everything that's driving in. How do you think that as the industry we are moving in to economize?
First of all, you know, starting with the point that, you know, companies don't have any option. Probably we as a organizations have missed the bus, because users have already gone ahead in terms of the way they are using the technology to, you know, whether it is to know more about the product or buy product. Most of the brands and products are using digital in a very, very passe style, probably. And the only way any brand can do a differential work, really to stand out in front of the customer or deliver the experience to customer, is by using data.
I agree with him that it's a tough one. And but having said that, I think certain industries, or the way the shift has happened, for example, a brand like Club Mahindra is possibly doing it. So we absolutely actually customize and personalize the communication that we do with our members. We're able to run about 35 to 40 campaigns every quarter. We have information on their holiday behavior completely, and we're able to suggest destinations to them. We're able to actually measure and impact the demand that they make of us. It is in our interest to get them to holiday during off-peak season.
On that point, yesterday I was actually spending some time with Google, and we actually found out that Tata Housing has sold around 80 flats yesterday online. Now, given that the fact and the appliance getting sold in real online, have you changed the way, Ramesh, you looked at planning from an offline point of view with the digital data?
If you look at the way the industry is evolving now, and the way, for us, e-commerce is very small, but we believe that it's the future. You know, like when the modern retail came into India, and we all laughed at it and said it's never going to establish, because we all prefer to go to mom and pop stores and then the kind of service which you get. So that's where we are in terms of when it comes to the e-commerce platform. So, but I guess the way Flipkart and others are playing the game, and the way the market is going to open up, there's going to be a huge change that's going to happen.
We actually look at how to incrementally give something better to customer, the way we have defined customer's happiness. It is not the way customer has defined his happiness. The way we have defined, he said, okay, previously I used to get X, now I'll get X plus Y, so he should be more happier this time. So I guess that not really help. And if you look at most of the online companies or the online business which has grown, they have not come from the existing offline businesses. No, none of the sector, existing offline businesses, really made it bigger enough online. You know, there'll be hardly any case study. You'll find that.
Is there a danger about over-investing in technology? You know, are marketeers overreacting in some way? You've not studied the animal completely yet.
You are absolutely right. There is always, always an opportunity and a scenario in which investments in technology could be an overkill. But that is true of almost anything that you do in business.
The first sale, when we did 26 Jan sale, it was supposed to be a one-day sale. And a store karta took a call that I'm going to extend it for 3 days, because he saw the crowds and he didn't even bother to call anybody. He just took a call, Ram, and he went up on a, there was no time. He stood up, took a megaphone and announced that, please, I am not able to service all of you today. Come back tomorrow and day after. So by the evening, I think people realized so eventually the message got to Kishore Bina by the evening. He called up the store karta and said, thank you very much. You found us a solution.
I don't think digital usage of digital medium or any other should be the responsibility of CMO alone. Earlier we used to say the brand sits at the heart of the business, not in the office of the marketing manager or a CMO, you know. Similar way, you have to create an organization which is digitally savvy, right from the CEO to your service guy, because service is the biggest interface, not a marketing guy. And how do you equip your service guys to use all the possible platforms and tools to reach out to consumers? Because as he rightly said, you know, there are, most of the times, consumers will never write about good experience. He will not take that effort.
When we get on to investing online, right? There has to be a mind shift change, not with us, with also them. Okay, so I don't want to name a brand where I pulled out a campaign because they said, I am a branding site. I can only give you clicks. I said, clicks is a very old thought, school of thought.
is that, you know, why should we need to, you know, earn our money? We need to prove it. Now we've gone to a stage where we've proved it a lot by saying that, okay, fine, you can get a CPC at this rate or a CPL or a sale. And that number is actually, you know, reducing by the day. And saying if you're getting a 10 rupee CPC to the point where 5 rupee CPC that you can get. Now, I would say, in a way, it's sold in the wrong way. It's not necessary that, you know, we have to be blamed or the other side has to be blamed. But somewhere down the line, I think so, the entire way that we sold this entire thing, in a way, it was more metrics related.
Are these media who are online are also thinking digital for themselves, not in terms of creating experience, but rightly, as rightly said, how are you pulling the people onto your side? I don't think that is happening. I have a good site, I have a brand, and people will automatically come in. I'm sorry, that age is gone.
I think it's an excellent place to have a freewheeling discussion on issues that are close to the CMO's heart within the context of digital. And Vijaya put together a very interesting group, but we are all digital converts. So look forward to more such discussions and maybe different formats.
This was one of the most electrifying discussion which we found. We were trying to restrict it to 1 hour, but it has gone beyond that, and the kind of questions started coming in. This is a clear indication that we are now setting up into a next era of digital.
The best part about AdGully Forum is the kind of speaker list that is always there. It's good to interact with people who are leading this whole digitization and understand how digital is impacting different businesses, and that is very, very, very critical. That's what I think is the best part about the AdGully forums.
So one thing I'd look at is, earlier these discussions would typically happen among just the digital guys. Now you've got CMOs and the like coming in and talking, and see, it's a therefore a larger part of the ecosystem, and we're talking about how to use digital rather than debating which is better, which is not better. So that's been a good thing in this particular thing, and I hope such things continue, and good for industry at large.
I think it's a great forum because it has brought the CMOs from different industries discuss a very interesting topic on the digital consumers and what is the trend which we're seeing in digital media. I think it is important for all of us to see and learn from each other, and also see what is happening in the market. Digital is something which is here to stay, whether we are in print or in travel or in insurance or in consumer durable, we all can really learn from the trend and the way customer is interacting in the digital medium and gain from it. Thank you so much.
So AdGully Forum signs off, but we promise to give you more, and the party still on.